You thought you could just fuck with us, and we wouldn't fuck with you? Just so you know, they died like dogs. And you weren't there to help them.
There's always someone who wanted someone else dead. Sometimes just roughed up, but dead was usually what they wanted. Sometimes they thought they could cheat me. That was usually only when I first arrived somewhere. Didn't matter to me. I just took it as part of the job. Little extra thrown in for free. I always got paid in the end, one way or another.
Mind if we...
I didn't care where I was going. Ended up mostly wandering east. Getting as far away from San Francisco as I could, maybe.
Sit down.
Suit yourself.
I probably would have had to go through the door, I'm guessing. But anyways, I'm gonna see a lot of these, see if they can tell us anything.
Finally ended up in the Commonwealth.
Mr. Kellogg, I'm glad you decided to meet with me.
So?
The first synths weren't all that impressive. I'm good, but I'm not that good. But the Institute could always make more, and kept making them better each time. They still give me the creeps, but you have to get used to them if you want to work with the Institute.
Institute.
You heard all sorts of rumors about the Institute, but I figured they were just a convenient boogeyman for anything bad that ever happened. They were real, all right. They didn't know anything about operating on the surface. Relied on their synths for everything. They had the resources I needed, and I had the expertise they needed. Turned into a permanent arrangement. It suited me just fine.
I wanted to see for myself.
If you're wondering how I did it, I kind of cheated, used a rocket launcher, a Molotov, and a Fat Man.
Why we didn't just
that's about it.
The rest of them. But we had our orders. I guess the old man didn't want so many loose ends. Too bad he left alive the one person he shouldn't have.
Oh, yeah, the TV, because it said please stand by. I am an idiot.
Slow movements, okay? I don't know what kind of side effects the procedure might have had. No one's ever done this before. How do you feel?
Awful.
I have this burning feeling inside my skull. It's like it's on fire.
That That's not surprising. All the synapses in your brain have just been pulled apart, connected to someone else, and then pulled back together. I injected you with a large stim pack while I was pulling you out. That should ease things. Huh. Are you ready to talk about what happened in there?
There's more than one person who knows about the Institute. Virgil, that scientist who escaped.
I didn't know Institute scientists could defect. This changes everything. He could answer all sorts of questions. Where did the memory say he was? The glowing sea? That can't be right. No one would risk going there. Not even to hide.
That's why he's there. To make the Institute think twice about following him.
That must be it. He's using the radiation and the glowing sea like a shield or a cloak, a way to throw them off and be at an advantage. If Virgil found a way to survive, you'll have to do the same. If you're going to follow him.
Yeah, anti-radiation.
How do I fight that much radiation, Doctor?
There are chemical compounds. Rad-X, Rad-Away. You'd need as much as you could carry. Maybe more. A sealed environment suit would be great, if you could find one. Or maybe one of those suits of power armor? That would be perfect.
Oh, I'm going in naked. Fingers crossed I get superpowers.
I know you're joking, but as a doctor, I feel obligated to remind you that unprotected radioactive exposure will only kill you. Dead. D-E-A-D. So be sure you find a way to get through there with your life intact. And good luck. By the way, I unplugged Mr. Valentine first. Removed the implant while you were waking up. He's waiting for you upstairs.
Great. Well, Doc, I have to say that was fun. I'm just gonna... Yoink. All right, Nick, where are you? Amazing how downstairs it says take, and yet upstairs it's a seal. Ooh. Do I dare? Nah, maybe another time. Right now I got things to do. Where's Nick? Nick!
The memory den's not accepting new clients right now, sweetheart.
I might have passed him. New? I heard him. I'm just gonna get in this first. Oh, there you are.
Nick.
Hope you got what you were looking for inside my head. I was right. I should have killed you when you were on ice.
Okay.
Is that you?
What? What are you talking about?
You sounded like Kellogg just then.
Did I? Mari said there might be some mnemonic impressions left over. Anyway, I feel fine, so let's get going.
We have to head into the glowing sea. Any advice?
I'm a synth. So radiation isn't much of an issue for me. But that suit of power armor you've got on might be the guardian angel you're looking for. That, or you could buy up all the Rad-X and Rad-Away you can find from any chem dealer who's got it in stock.
Let's get going, Nick.
Been one heck of a ride so far. Let's see where it takes us next.
Yeah.
Hey,
Where? Nick, we have to go. No time to send around, dude. I'll lead the way. Doop-a-doop-a-doop. By the way, I will cut out these load times because they do take a while sometimes.
Hey everyone, gather around. Let's get the breeze back. Shoot the fat. Now I know you all are doing your own thing, but I don't want anyone here to forget what matters. Hey, Daisy, glad you can make it. How's my favorite girl doing? Didn't I see you on a date with Rowski the other day?
He wishes.
All right, we're getting off track. What was I saying? Oh, that's right. What matters? We freaks gotta stick together. And the best way to stick together is to keep an eye out for what drives us apart. You feel me?
Yeah, you tell it like it is, Hancock.
Now, what out there in our big friendly Commonwealth would wanna drive us apart? What kind of twisted, unneighborly boogeyman would wanna hurt our peaceful community?
The Institute and their synths!
That's right. Who said that? Coming up to my office later, you've earned yourself some jet. The Institute. They're the real enemy. Not the Raiders. Not the super mutants. Not even those tools over in Diamond City.
I don't know, Hancock. I'd sure love to give McDonough a kick in the ass.
Hey, we all know I got my own personal beef with that lardhead. But stay focused.
Gunner?
I want everyone to keep the
What's
Institute
a
in mind. When someone starts acting funny. When people are doing things they don't normally do. When family starts pushing you away for no reason. We all know who's behind that kind of shit. And the only way to stop it is to stick together. They can't control us if we're not afraid. Now, who's scared of the Institute?
Not us!
And which town in the Commonwealth should the Institute not fuck with?
Good neighbor! Good neighbor.
And who's in charge of good neighbor?
Of the people! For the people!
Huh. Well, hello. Everything here is guaranteed to injure, maim, or kill at your discretion. Except me. I only kill when I want to.
What are you?
What are you?
I'm a woman, baby. Can't you tell?
Okay. Well, good for you.
Oh, of course you are. It's just all those metal plates. You're a robot, right? A very womanly robot.
Was that a pickup line? I've heard better. Are you buying anything?
Ow.
So what kinds of weapons do you have?
Anything that can kill a man, I sell. Except suicidal depression. That is unfortunately not packageable. Now, are we doing business?
Let's see what you have.
Murder and mayhem at a discount.
Aw, you're such a doll. Get that. A cryogenic grenade? Huh. New. Focus boost laser pistol. Ooh, light combat rifle. And it's got a longer barrel. Got a minigun somewhere. Party starter. Damn! That's a lot of money for a missile launcher. Plasma grenade. I am 44. Peril. Oh, I do need ammo. I can buy some ammo, I guess. Not that much, though. Let's get 18 of these. Two of these. Yeah, these, I guess. Keep the 50s to ourselves. 10 millimeters, I think we get plenty of those, don't we? Let's see. Yeah, 354, yeah, I get plenty of those. 5.6, flame fuel, flare. Fusion core. Amazing how these are the most expensive thing they have. But I guess it's understandable. I do need missiles, though. I can only get one missile, though. So, no. Shotgun shells. How many shells do we got? 32? No, we're good. Okay. Oh. That was certainly interesting. I mean, that is interesting how a lot of the game, it definitely shows, like, what it can do, especially with his rating and the barter system. It is pretty easy. But my god, is everything expensive. Alright? For me, I think it's better to, like, to just scavenge just off of people. I mean, granted, you probably find less, but at least it's a lot better than shilling out so much money just to actually get about one bullet. I mean, it just seems so expensive to me. I could literally be the only one who thinks this. I'll still fight him. I still have tons of missions that I need to do. I'm gonna go do some of these other missions before we continue on with the main story mission. I actually kind of find it ingenious that people were able to make pipe weapons and so well. I guess it kind of makes sense. It's kind of the same material. Alright, so... Oh, these guys.
Quiet, Yiffy. All right, you. Tell me. Diamond City Radio? It's terrible, yes? Makes you want to cut your own ears off.
Tired of living in and you maybe want a...
Yeah, no, I haven't noticed.
I don't think I noticed.
You listen to it. It grates on ears like sandpaper. This DJ Travis, he is disaster. Something must be done and...
Yeah.
We will have customers suiciding before long.
Vadim!
It's true! Don't listen to my brother. Someone needs to get rid of him. We need a new DJ for the radio.
I don't think many would notice if he, you know, disappeared.
Yeah, no, seriously?
Are you serious?
Did we not just agree this is a serious problem? Calls for serious solution. First, you get him to follow you out of town.
If this is a joke,
that's
you're
enough.
One sick
Vadim
puppy,
isn't
buddy.
Serious. He doesn't really want to kill Travis.
Yeah, no, he seems serious.
He seems pretty serious to me.
No. He was only kidding, right, Vadim?
It's true. Only jokes. Travis is a good friend. Yefim and I worry about him.
Well, Travis, he means well, but he does not have the confidence he needs for that job, or anything else, really. And so he's always awkward. He does not believe in himself, you see? He expects he will fail at everything, and so he does.
Well, that can always be turned around.
Exactly. This is what I'm telling you, Fim. Go on, spoil sport. Go back to working. We will figure out how to help Travis. Come, you. Meet me in back room. We discuss plan.
Okay.
You keep that synth freak at arm's length. You understand me?
Hey, buddy, there's a thing called tolerance. Try it sometime. So, the back room's a kitchen.
Returning customers.
All right.
Most die. You let me know if you need a drink.
Just looking.
Your call.
Wait. So do I not meet him there, or...? What? Yeah, no, I was gonna say, can you just give me a mission?
Okay, let us get down to brass tacks. I am glad you are willing to help. Unlike my deadbeat brother, Travis is a good guy. He deserves better life.
Mm-hmm. Alright, so I'm happy to help out,
Okay, so Travis needs to believe in himself, yes? Believe he is capable of more. You know what works well for this? A bar fight. Ever been in one?
Yeah, I hold my own.
I can hold my own, if that's what you mean.
Yeah, quite the scrapper, this one.
Exactly what I mean. I want you
Thanks,
to
Nick.
Set up Travis in his first fight. I want to stage fight here in Dugga. Nothing too serious. We make sure Travis wins and feels good about himself after. I want you to be there to help make it look real. What do you think? Sound good to you?
Hmm.
Gonna need some more information.
Okay. I have this all thought out. I have
contacts. Oh, good.
People I can count on. Real tough looking. But they will take a dive for money. They confront Travis here at dugout. You step in and give him push he needs to stand up to them. Then you and Travis take them down. Nothing gets too rough. And Travis is something he can feel good about. Simple, right?
Okay, the last few times I've asked for money, it hasn't worked out. So, I might be lucky? First, let's ask why involve me.
You have seen Travis, yes? He cannot fight alone, not even fake one. He needs help. You can help. I have everything ready by 6 o'clock. Travis should be here by then. You show up and it will go well. Promise.
Okay. Or we could just do this. Well. I guess I'll just put my suit over here. I don't know why I pulled it out. And now we wait. What time is it? 4? So...
Come, come, have a drink. I didn't buy bar to sell water.
Wait. Oh, after 6. Okay.
Come, come. Say something. Anything.
I don't need anything.
Fine, fine.
I'm waiting. Now allow me to wait. What time is it? Oh, it's at 6 p.m., so... All right, here we go.
Ah, yes, you.
Travis.
Hey, I mean, hi. Again, hi.
Aw, you're shy.
Hey, Travis.
Okay. I usually don't. This is why.
Never been up in the stands? Let's just say they can afford a lot of clothes.
Look, I don't want any trouble.
I don't like you, and I don't like your radio. What you gonna do about it?
Can you just leave me alone?
Oh, what's wrong? Not so tough once you're not on the air.
Yeah!
Really?
Hey,
the best.
What's your problem?
Why are you bothering Travis?
Why are you getting involved in something that don't matter to you? Now get the hell out of here.
So, this radio station. Hey, hi.
Again.
Well, some people help hi? Here. People,
hi.
Need new clothes? Should stop by Fallett's basement. Open during the day.
Get lost.
But that's okay, because he only serves one thing.
Hey.
What's your problem?
End of the World by Skeeter Davis.
Looks like you're having a disagreement.
Look at the smart guy we got here. Except, if you read...
I'm a woman, sir.
Smart. You take a hike right about now. Now get the hell out of here.
Hey.
What's your problem?
You're the problem, pal.
You're sticking your nose someplace it don't belong. Best stay out of it. Now get the hell out of here.
Hi.
Beat it, lady.
Okay. I usually don't. This is why. This is
get
why.
Lost.
Hey.
What's your problem?
I'd like you to leave Travis alone.
Yeah, well, I'd like a million caps. Looks like both of us are gonna be disappointed today. Now get the hell out of here.
Hey, I mean, hi. Again, hi.
I got you in my suit armor. Really? Seriously?
Again, hi? Hi.
Beat it, lady.
Vadim.
What the hell is wrong with you? You were supposed to help Travis in fight, not murder people in my bar. Why would you think this is okay?
It won't happen again.
It can't happen again, because they were the only two guys I knew willing to do this. You have screwed this up big time. I will try and fix the situation which you have made messing of. In meantime, I need you to not kill anyone and help with the rest of the plan. Okay? You have seen Scarlet, yes? She has worked here for some time. Now, I am just simple bartender, but I see things. I see how Travis looks at her, and I see that sometimes she looks at him. If someone who was not her employer suggests that she go spend time with Travis, it might do him some good.
Why do I have to be involved in this?
Think about it. I am Scarlett's boss. I tell her she needs to go see Travis. Suddenly she is thinking she is no longer just waitress. Apparently I also need to say, please do not be killing anyone. Okay? This is for helping Travis, not murdering for fun.
Just do whatever it
takes. Ruin my fun.
Get her to agree to see Travis, and this will all be worth it. And you and I never talked about this, all right?
Complications.
Did you see that blimp thing? Brotherless thing.
Yeah, you do something nice for a person, it blows up in your face. And then they tell you, you're not supposed to kill. I mean, it's not like I knew I was going to kill with sharp knuckles. I mean, granted, I should have seen that coming, but, you know. There she is.
Miss?
I'm on a break right now.
Sorry to have bothered you.
No problem. I'm on a break right now.
Can I ask you something personal? It's about Travis.
Travis? Really? Did he mention me? I heard about the fight.
What?
Travis was... Well, he was brave.
Yeah. Yeah, it was.
Absolutely. You should really pay him a visit.
You think? I mean, I've definitely noticed him. Maybe... No. No, I couldn't just go over there.
Look, Travis is a nice guy. I can tell that you like him. And I think he likes you. Just go talk to him.
Please.
Yeah, I will. I'll go see him now. Thanks.
Yes. Yay. Okay, now go talk to Vildum. Yay. Okay, that was easy enough.
Heard there was some trouble.
I knew it. He was up to no good, and look what's happened now. You've got to help. I can't do it. You've got to help me.
How about a bit of good news?
Help with what?
What are you talking about?
I am talking about Vadim. They took him. Men came in. They said they're friends of the ones you killed. Said Vadim owed them money because of what happened. He wouldn't pay, but they grabbed him and said that they would make him pay. And then they just dragged him out. You have to do something. Please tell me you can do something.
Do you know where?
Do you know where they took him?
No, I don't know. He's the one that's has always dealt with them. I've tried to avoid them. Travis might know. You should ask him, please. I don't want anything to happen to Vadim.
Well, to the power armor. Da-da-da-da-da.
Don't let all that horsepower go to your head.
Now, your witty banter may need to wait, Nick. We have people to save. Away! Nick, I know you're probably boning, but I need you.